Hi guys, it's Tana Mongeau. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel.
Wild child Tana Mongeau has been busy launching her own talent agency, working on releasing a podcast, a food brand, and even an alcohol line, Dizzy. Amidst all of that, she had to find time to move out of her modern mansion in Sherman Oaks she'd been renting since 2018. Tana has now moved into fellow YouTuber David Dobrik's former Studio City home, but there's some confusion as to whether he's her landlord or she purchased the house. Her new abode has been renovated and expanded since it was built in 1953, boasts 2,900 square feet of space and an indoor-outdoor vibe, and today we're gonna take a look. We even found the listings. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. There are influencers, and then there's Tana Mongeau. The outspoken internet personality and content creator first gained popularity for her storytime videos on YouTube, but these days she boasts multi-millions of followers and subscribers across all platforms. Now, outside of the 23-year-old's success on social media, she's expanded her ambitions into the real world, launching Tana's Angels Agency to potentially entering the YouTube boxing scene as the first female influencer to do so. Not to mention she's launching a podcast called Cancelled, a food brand called Only Foods, and even an exclusive alcohol line. All things considered, she's amassed an estimated net worth of at least $4 million or more, and it seems she's only getting started. While Tana has snagged David Dobrik's old pad in Studio City to call home, she still said she would miss her old place. She often lives with many of her friends, and her old rental mansions were large enough to fit them all. It even boasted an elevator. Hey guys, I'm Kara the Vampire Slayer, back with another exclusive house tour here on Famous Entertainment. Today, we're checking out the homes of influencer Tana Mongeau, which includes the new party pad she picked up off of David Dobrik. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe and ring that bell for notifications because we post brand new content daily. As always, you can follow me over on Instagram to chat, and now let's get into this video. David Dobrik's $2.5 million LA home now has a new owner, and it's none other than Tana herself. She tweeted that she never thought in a million years that she would be buying a house from David Dobrik. The influencer then went on to call David her new landlord, which confused fans, considering if she bought the home, she wouldn't have a landlord.
What do you mean by that?
Either way, David had bought the starter home in 2017 and moved to a larger estate since, and the hillside property is located in Studio City, boasting panoramic views of Universal Studios and even the wizarding world of Harry Potter. I mean, the house seems pretty basic to me, but being that close to Hogwarts, okay, now I'm jealous. Well, Tana is either renting or has purchased the Studio City property, but it hasn't been made clear yet. While it's not where she was formerly living in Sherman Oaks, Studio City is just over the hill from the Hollywood bus, offering tree-lined streets and the lively Ventura Boulevard. Other features in the neighborhood include Willacre Park for hiking and trendy dining. Tana recently posted on Instagram, which I definitely saw, and in her stories about how much she was going to miss her old house, even saying, "Really gonna miss having an elevator, SMH crying over moving." And sadly, her new spot definitely doesn't have an elevator, or even a pool for that matter. Other stories of Tana's showed her partying in her previous house with her friends and shedding tears over the move. Oh well. David was trying to unload his home for $3.495 million as reported back in June, and if he gets this much for the estate or even close to it, he's making a profit. Records show he paid less than $2.6 million for the property. Tana's new abode was built in 1953, but upgraded, expanded, and renovated a lot since then, creating a new, somewhat contemporary style structure. Inside, the home spans almost 2,900 square feet of space with 4 beds and 3.5 baths, but since Tana almost always has a group of friends and staff living with her, I wonder if that space is gonna be enough. Her new party pad was built in a vague style, but it's a bit like a Spanish villa on the outside with a red tiled roof and hacienda build. House is situated in almost 3/4 acre behind gates on a quiet cul-de-sac, while inside, the decor features a lot of white and feels anonymous. Vlog Squad fans would have seen the property many times as it was often featured in David's videos. Other features throughout the home include hardwood floors, spacious living and dining areas in an open feel. All of the bathrooms here have en-suites, and the office could act as the fourth bedroom. We do know Tana had found the perfect selfie spot in her former sprawling mansion, like her mirrored landing on the open-air staircase. But I wonder if her new, much more simple abode will have a spot that's Instagram-worthy. The open-plan common spaces include a dining room with modern light fixture overhead and glass sliders out to the yard, as well as a kitchen fitted with top-of-the-line Wolf and Sub-Zero appliances. Something tells me that Tana doesn't do too much cooking in her spare time, but there's enough space for whoever's doing the meal prep here. There's also a cute living room with sleek built-in fireplace, as well as a spacious master suite for Tana. Of course, like many spaces in the abode, her room also features direct access to the grounds through glass sliders. The outdoor space has got to be the best feature of the property because it overlooks amazing views of the San Fernando Valley. There's a grassy lawn and terraces perfect to entertain, as well as an outdoor kitchen, barbecue, and more. My favorite spot back here is the stylish outdoor fire pit with seating area, but the only thing this yard is missing is a swimming pool. I mean, what multi-million dollar LA home doesn't have a pool? That's a deal breaker for me. Considering Tana has some sort of impressive rooftop-ish pool at her former abode, I don't think it'll be long until she's missing that feature too. In usual Tana fashion, it hasn't been all smooth sailing since the move either. Aside from being nostalgic about her old home, she also posted an update saying she thinks her new place, or David's old place, is haunted. Not to mention, fans have apparently found Tana's new address and actually are showing up at the property. On July 14th, the social media star asked fans to please stop showing up to her house via Twitter. While David lived here, he already had the ongoing issue with fans showing up, and he publicized the move on social media as well, so some feel that Tana was essentially asking for it. What do you guys think? Now, let's compare the new house with Tana's longtime rental abode located in Sherman Oaks, Los Angeles, the one that she seems to miss so much. Back in 2019, Tana showed off her house tour on her YouTube channel, and we can see the mansion boasted 6,000 square feet of space with 6 beds, 6.5 baths, and an Olympic-sized swimming pool. Okay, we can already see it's double the size of the new place, and it had that awesome pool. There was also some jungle-type pathway on the property that seemed pretty cool and was full of lush plants. Inside, Tana's former mansion featured open-plan living spaces with tons of natural lights and hardwood flooring such as the spacious living or family room, floor-to-ceiling windows, and sky-high views of LA. Records show that Tana had been renting this sprawling pad since 2018 for over $13,000 per month. However, if you follow Tana on Instagram, then you'd note the home that she takes all of those mirror selfies on the staircase at looks like somewhere completely different. Honestly, everyone thought that she moved into the famous Hype House last year, but she took to Twitter in 2020 to deny that. So the latest rental mansion that she misses so dearly wasn't actually that Sherman Oaks home. It was this one that she showed off on her Instagram. And it happens to have the exact same Hollywood pool as the Hype House. Interesting. Well, it doesn't matter anymore. Anyways, considering she's moved on to the Studio City house now. So I think it's time to bring our Tana Mongeau house tour to an end. Honestly, I'm wondering if her living at David Dobrik's former pad is temporary, because comparing the new Studio City house to her old rentals, it just doesn't compare. For Tana's lifestyle and all her friends that seem to also live at her mansions and her partying, the new home just doesn't seem big enough. And the property doesn't even have a pool. We'll just have to see how long that lasts. Did you guys have a favorite feature in her new house, or how about in her old rental pad? I gotta say, that staircase selfie spot at Tana's old mansion was to die for. Be sure to let me know what you think about Tana moving into David Dobrik's old home in the comments down below. Also, did she buy it or is she renting? I am so confused. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye!